This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, so I was telling you that tenses make the most integral part of our day-to-day conversations. Whenever we speak to somebody, the correct usage of tenses let us know as to whether the thing happened currently, is it going to happen in future, or has it happened in the past. So whenever we have any ambiguity regarding tenses, we often tend to change the entire meaning of our conversation. So it is very necessary that in what context of chronological order or time we are speaking to somebody. I hope everyone can hear me clearly. Aruna, can you hear me properly? Okay, fine. So after making a thorough research and formulating a technical aspect to clarify the OET examination, the members of TCU Academy came to a conclusion that the past tense is the one out of all the three tenses that confuse the students most of the times. The past tense confuses us. Why? Why does the past tense confuse us? Because the past tense again has two major types of differences, or we can say two different type of distinctions amongst itself. That is the simple past and the past perfect. Now we know that perfect tense is a past. So when we say simple past, I will explain to you what simple past is. But whenever we say past present, it means that you are making the past of the past. For example, 2 raised to the power 2 is equals to 4. 2 raised to the power 2, or according to the language of mathematics, we can say that 2 square is equals to 4. That is, 2 raised to the power 2 is equals to 4. So you can just imagine that first type of tense that we have is the simple past. The next type of the tense that we have is the past perfect. And past perfect is almost, I mean, just for the sake of understanding, you can imagine that past raised to the power 2. I'm writing it for you. Let me write it for you so that you can clearly understand as to what I'm actually trying to say. First of all, we have the past simple tense. So you can say that this is past raised to the power 1. Past raised to the power 1. And when we say past perfect, this is just for the sake of understanding. I mean, there is no relation of mathematics over here, but just for the sake of understanding, let us just assume that this is what it somewhat looks like. This is what I was trying to tell you. This is how it looks. So the only type of tense in which the students confuse the most is which one? Is the past tense. Because again, in past tense, we have two varieties. There is a simple past and the past perfect. So just for the sake of understanding, you can imagine that the simple past is past raised to the power 1. That is, she slept. I played cricket. This is simple past. I played cricket. But when we come to the past perfect, you imagine that we are making the past of the past. We are making the past of the past. Now I will make you understand how do we do it. Let us see it in our further slides to come. Now, first of all, the past tense. The past tense in English, why is it used? And how is it used in relevance to the occupational English test? Because whenever we discuss any grammatical aspect of the English language, we are trying to lay our emphasis upon the OET examination. So what relevance and what significance does the past tense make or draw over upon the OET examination? Let us see. It is used to talk about the past, the happenings or the events that occurred in the past. Secondly, to talk about a hypothesis or imagination. Past tense is also used to talk about a hypothesis or an imagination. The third uses for politeness. For example, in the last paragraph of your occupational English test writing section of your referral, discharge or transfer letter, what do you do? You request your doctor, I would highly be honored. So we use would, could, if you could assist the patient in doing so and that and blah blah blah. So the past tense is made the excessive use in the third paragraph of the OET writing section. So these are the certain uses that I have listed over on your screens in which the past tense is heavily made use of. How? To talk about the past, to make hypotheses and imaginations, and for politeness. So now, among the past, as I told you that we have different varieties among this past tense. And what are those varieties? The first type of tense is the simple past. And you can recognize any sentence that this sentence is in the simple past by recognizing only the verb used in it. So in simple past tense, the second form of verb is used. How? I played cricket. She slept. Or you can say, they have arrived. I went to school. Now went is the second form of go. Go, went and gone. There are three forms of go. Go, went and gone. So they went to school. Now went is in second form. So which sentence is this? This is the simple past. Why have we recognized this sentence as the simple past? Because it comprises of the second form of the verb. Let us see the next type of sentence. The past perfect. And how would you recognize tense is a past perfect tense? If there is had and the third form of the verb. They had eaten their food. They had eaten their food. They had gone to school. They had gone to school. Had and the third form of go. The next variety is the continuous, past continuous tense. And how do we recognize it? Was verb plus ing. I was going to school. This is what? I was going to school is what? I was going to school. This is past continuous tense. And the fourth type of tense is the past perfect continuous. Past perfect continuous, it comprises a mixture of perfect and continuous, that is had, been, plus ing. And of course, the third form of the verb. Second form of the verb. So now let us see the uses of past that I told you. To talk about the past, how? Miss Hector was diagnosed with arthritis. She was experiencing pain in the joints for the last 2 years. This sentence is in the simple past. Miss Hector was diagnosed with arthritis. She was experiencing pain in the joints for the last 2 years. Now, this sentence is indeed an amalgamation of two sentences. There are two sentences in this paragraph. What are those? Miss Hector was diagnosed with arthritis, simple past. She was experiencing pain in the joints for the last 2 years. This is what? Past continuous tense. Past continuous tense. So did you see? We have two varieties of tenses in this one paragraph. The first is in the past simple tense. The second sentence is in the past continuous tense. Let us look at one more example. For example, he was working at McDonald's. He had been working there since July. He was working at McDonald's. Which tense is this? Can you write in the chat window? Which tense is this? He was working at McDonald's. Please write in your chat windows as to which tense is this. He was working at McDonald's. Yes, Reena, Ashwarya, past continuous. Fasiha, Ashwarya, Lissy, Tabua, ST, Deeksha, Manpreet, past continuous. Everybody very nice. Very nicely told. Everybody, Imam, Hajra, Ajogbe, very nice. Aruna, Noreen. So this is, which tense was it? It was the past continuous tense. It was the past continuous tense. The second sentence, he had been working there since July. Which tense is this? He had been working there since July. Past perfect continuous. Fasiha, Reena, everybody, SD, very nice, everyone. The second sentence is the past perfect continuous. Now, the second usage of the past tense. The second usage of the past tense is, yes, Imam, Noreen, Tabua, user. Everybody of you, Hajra, very nice, nicely told. The second usage of the past tense is to refer to a hypothesis or an imagination. What a hypothesis? We just assume that something is going to happen. We imagine in our brains that something would happen in a way that we perceive. So if whenever we make a hypothesis, what we do? Whenever making a hypothesis, what do? We make use of the past tense. And how? Let us look. It might be dangerous. Suppose they got lost. It might be dangerous. Suppose they got lost. This is in the past tense. Suppose they got lost. Now something hasn't happened, but somebody is assuming what would happen if they get lost. So it is in the past tense. Suppose they got lost. Let us look at one more sentence. This surgery is very complex. Imagine the patient dies. Imagine the patient dies. Now I am writing this sentence in two forms that you could use in reference to your OET. Let us see how. Just look over here. This surgery is very complex. Imagine if the patient dies. The second type is, this surgery is very complex. What if the patient dies? Died. This surgery is very complex. Imagine if the patient died. This surgery is very complex. What if the patient died? Now, these are two types. These are two types of sentences in which we can make use of the past tense. And I have shown you a few examples as to how to make a very useful usage of the past tense while making hypotheses and imaginations. And this is how these sentences look like. It might be dangerous. Suppose they got lost. It might be dangerous. Suppose they got lost. The second type of sentence is, this surgery is very complex. Imagine the patient died. This surgery is very complex. What if the patient died? What if the patient died? For hypothesis, wishes, and conditions in the past, we make use of the past perfect tense. Let us see how. It was very dangerous. What if you had got lost? It was very dangerous. What if you had got lost? Now somebody is assuming, somebody is making again a hypothesis that it was very dangerous. What if you had got lost? Now here what we have done is that we have made usage of the past perfect tense. We have made the usage of the past perfect tense. Let us look at one more example. I wish I hadn't spent so much money last month. I wish I hadn't spent so much money last month. Now again, somebody is wishing, assuming something, and again we have made use of what? The past perfect tense. One more example we have in front of your screens. I would have helped him if he had asked. Now this sentence is a very complex sentence that people often make mistake whenever communicating or writing the language English. This is a hypothesis, and somebody is saying for his friend or relative or somebody else known to him, kin or kin, I would have helped him if he had asked. This is a very, very rare sentence. This is a very common sense sentence that we often make use of every day in our lives. Every day in our lives while speaking or communicating with somebody. So here we have made use of the past perfect tense. This is very necessary for you to recognize and to identify as to what tense you are making use of. Because until unless you would be able to identify the type of tenses you're using in your sentences, how then you would be able to derive to the concept and the how would you be able to fathom the concept of the tenses? And basically among all the type of tenses is specifically the past tense, because it is only the past tense that confuse the students most of the times. Most of the times, why? Because again, in the past tense, we have two different type of varieties. That is the simple past and the past perfect tense. And I told you when we initiated our session that you can mathematically understand the type of both of these type of tenses by a mathematical expression, that the past simple is just past raised to the power 1, and the past perfect is simply past raised to the power 2, or square of the past tense. If you know a little bit of mathematics, you would be able to understand as to what I'm actually trying to say. For making wishes, again, I explained to you previously that for making wishes, what we do, we make usage of the past tense. I wish the patient recovers after taking treatment from you. Now somebody is making a wish. I wish the patient recovers after taking treatment from you. I wish it wasn't raining. I wish it wasn't raining. I wish it was not raining. Now again, this is the past tense. Of course, the second sentence is not in the past tense. Let us convert into the past tense. I wish the patient had recovered after taking treatment from you. Now we have converted these both sentences in the past tense. Now somebody is making a wish. The patient was admitted to a doctor, and somebody is making a wish that I wish the patient had recovered after taking treatment from you. This means that the patient did not recover. The patient did not recover. So somebody is assuming. Somebody is assuming. Kindly look at both the sentences attentively. And if you have any query, please write to me in the chat. So in the second sentence, what have we done is that in the second sentence, the patient has not recovered after taking treatment from a doctor. So somebody is saying that I wish the patient had recovered after taking treatment from you. Now, as I told you, to be polite while writing an OET letter, often in the last section of the letter, we tend to become a bit polite, while towards the completion of the letter, we tend to be polite while writing the letter. So whenever we want to be polite, we make use of the past tense. Let us see how. Excuse me, I was wondering if this was the train for York. Did you see? I was wondering if this was the train for York. Now, this is a polite expression. The train is on the platform. The train is on the platform and it hasn't left. So somebody is asking the station master or somebody else that I was wondering if this was the train for York. So this means that the train hasn't left. It's still on the platform and it is just a polite way of asking a favor from somebody or asking for an information from somebody. So whenever we want to be polite while asking or asking for favors or information from somebody, we make use of the past tense. And this is how we have done it. I just hoped you would be able to help me. I just hoped you would be able to help me. Again, we have made use of the past tense. Again, whenever we use if, we use the past tense. He could get a new job if he really tried. He could get a new job if he really tried. So somebody is saying that someone can get a new job if he tries. And here, while having if in a sentence, what we have done is that we have made use of the past tense. If Jack was playing, they would probably win. Now somebody is saying that a team was playing a match and they lost. A team was playing a match and they lost. So somebody is saying that if had Jack been there in the team, had Jack been there in the team, they would have won. So if Jack was playing, they would probably win. Now let us look at the past simple tense. So I told you that the past simple tense make use of what? The second form of verb. And I told you one more trick to understand the past simple tense. And how is it? You can assume that this type of tense is past raised to the power one. Past raised to the power one. That is, we are only in the past. Let us see how. You can use the simple past tense if you have done something for your patient while the patient was admitted under your care. If the patient is admitted under your care, you make use of the simple past tense. Let us look at a few examples. We performed daily dressings on Mr. Smith's surgical wound. Now the patient was under your care and you did something for your patient. So here you are making use of the past simple tense, the simple past tense. And what is simple past tense? The second form of the verb. The second form of the verb. Or you can say past raised to the power one. Past raised to the power one. Or the second form of the verb. So what is the verb here? What is the verb here? Perform. And performed is the second form of verb. Panadol was prescribed for the patient. Panadol was prescribed for the patient. Now, what is this prescribed? The second form of the verb. The second form of the verb is prescribed. So, whenever the patient was under your care or whenever the patient was admitted under your supervision, you did something for your patient. So, in the second paragraph of the letter, OET letter, what you have to do is that you make use of the simple past tense. You make use of the simple past tense because in the second part of the letter, you are explaining to somebody as to what you did for your patient when the patient was admitted under your care. I hope you are getting me with this notion. Jamie presented with tonsillitis for which I instituted penicillin. Jamie presented with tonsillitis for which I instituted penicillin. This is another example. A patient came to you with a problem and you did something for your patient and you're writing this in your OET letter. So you are making use of the simple past tense. One more example. During her visit, I discussed healthy dietary regimes and gave her brochures. During her visit, I discussed healthy dietary regimes and gave her brochures. For anything else that occurred during the patient's stay at hospital, anything else that happened to your patient when the patient was admitted under your care in the hospital. So what do? A meeting was held to discuss possible nursing procedures for the meeting. For the patient, however, the patient refused. So a meeting was held to discuss possible nursing procedures for the nursing. However, the patient refused. So what have we done? This was something that was done towards the patient for the welfare of the patient. And here we are making use of the simple past tense once again. Manpreet, you have asked a question to you, to me. For this, you can you have a query regarding however. Now, however, here is the connector, and we had previously taken classes on connectors, and very soon also we would be taking classes on connectors. If you have any query, you can watch the video on connectors on our YouTube channel, and very soon in days to come, I would be taking a session, a detailed session on connectors. Please do not forget to attend those classes. Stay tuned at Teach Your Academy. We will be informing you time to time as to when we are having a connector. Reena, the same goes for you also. We had taken in detail as to whether comma is used, semicolon is used for and however and other connectors. You can watch our video on YouTube, and very soon also we are going to take sessions on connectors, a balanced class for connectors. You can participate in that class also. You can request the founding members of Teach Your Academy. They can organize a class of mine very soon in days to come regarding connectors if you wish to. Therefore, a home assessment was conducted and modifications were made. Now, these are things that often we write in the second paragraph of the OET letter. May it be a transfer letter, may it be a discharge letter, or may it be a referral letter. So in the second paragraph of our OET letters, we make use of the simple past tense, wherein we are trying to emphasize upon the facts that took place with our patient when the patient was already admitted in our care, and we are referring or we are sending our patient for further assessment to another doctor or another nurse. Now, how do we understand simple past tense? I told you that you can understand the simple past tense when it has the second form of verb. Now, I told you one more thing, that the simple past tense is past raised to the power one. Now, you would be wondering that why is sir telling us past raised to the power one and past raised power two for the past perfect tense? I will let you know why. Suppose something started and ended in the past. Something started, and it ended in the past. We make use of the simple past tense. I'm writing some examples for you. The patient suffered major burns. Now, in this sentence, first of all, we have the second form of the verb, that is suffered. And we have an incident that took place in the past and ended in the past. Something started in the past and ended in the past. So the patient suffered major burns. This incident happened in the past and it ended in the past. Let us take one more example. The doctor prescribed antibiotics to the patient. The doctor prescribed antibiotics to the patient. Now something happened in the past and ended in the past. It has no relevance with the present. No relevance in the present. Now I'm writing one more sentence in front of you. And for this, I want one of you to unmute yourself and explain this sentence with regards to tense. So one of you unmute yourself and please explain to me the sentence that I have written on your screen. The sentence I have written on your screen with relevance to the tenses. Who's going to be active?
Hi, sir. It's Sonia.
Yes, Sonia. Welcome. Can you explain the relevance of the sentence?
Yeah, it is present perfect. The have is perfect, yes, and played third form of verb.
Okay. But you know, Sonia, I wanted to know the relevance of this sentence. I mean, what actually happened? I mean, what is currently happening? I mean, how do you understand it?
Sir, can I talk?
Hi.
Who? Deeksha?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, Deeksha,
go on.
Mate played.
They have played the match. That means they have started the match in the past, but it's still continuing.
Very nice, Deeksha. Very good. Very good. Somebody else? What about the boys? Boys never speak.
Hi.
Hi. Who are we speaking to?
My name is Jabi. This sentence is present perfect. And it shows they started their match in the past and just they have finished the match. Past is connected to the present.
Yes. The past is connected to the present. Very nice. The answer of Jabin was the most perfect answer. And I am writing, this is the present. This is the present perfect tense. And the difference here, as Jabin told us, is that something started in the past and it just finished. It has just finished in the present. Something started in the past and it has just finished in the present. So this is why this is the present perfect tense. And what about this sentence? Let us see. What about another sentence I'm going to write on your screens? They had played the match. They had played the match. Now, the thing about this sentence is this, that this is the past perfect tense. The past perfect tense. Now let us understand the simple past tense once again. Whenever we refer to the simple past tense, something started and ended in the past. Something started and ended in the past. For example, the patient suffered major burns. The suffering has finished in the past. The suffering finished in the past. And the doctor prescribed antibiotics to the patient. This thing initiated and ended in the past. But about this sentence, they have played the match. This situation started in the past, but finished in the present. So this is the present perfect tense. Now let us look at the past perfect tense. with reference to the past perfect tense, something started in the past, ended in the past, and a new event started in the past. Something started in the past, ended in the past. Just listen to me, there are two events. Whenever we use the past perfect tense, the simple past tense has one event. The past perfect tense has two events. Two events. Something started in the past, ended in the past, and another event started, that too in the past and finished in the past. So there are two events. Let us look at the example. This is why I told you that past perfect tense is the square of past. The square of past. And the simple past is the past raised to the power 1. And past perfect is past raised to the power 2. The patient had undergone a bypass surgery when he suffered a second stroke. Now there are two situations. The patient underwent a bypass surgery and he suffered a second stroke. Both these situations happened in the past. So this sentence is in the past perfect tense. This sentence is in the past perfect tense. Why? Because something happened, started in the past. The bypass surgery started in the past, ended in the past. And something else happened in the past. Something else happened in the past. Another example. Mrs. Carmel had taken insulin after lunch. Mrs. Carmel had taken insulin after lunch. Now let me explain to you this more properly. For example, we have a sentence over here. Doctor had left patient arrived. The doctor had left when the patient had arrived. Now this sentence, the doctor had left when the patient arrived, is actually an amalgamation of two sentences. What are those sentences? The first sentence is the doctor left. The second sentence is the patient arrived. Now both these sentences are in the past. So the past perfect tense is basically past perfect tense. Is basically passed into past, passed into past, or you can say past raised to the power 2. Past raised to the power 2. Now we'll understand this, the past perfect tense, with this example. The doctor had left when the patient arrived. Now there are two incidents. The doctor had left, the patient arrived. There are two things that started and ended in the past. So this is the past perfect tense. I hope with this notion you are able to understand. If you have entirely got everything regarding the present perfect tense, the simple past tense and the past perfect tense, please write Y in your chat windows. If you have a confusion, write N. If you have understood, write Y. If you have a problem, write N.
Hi, sir. I want to ask some question.
Yes, please go on.
Yeah, you just wrote the message. The text. They had played the match. So it is past perfect.
They had played the match. This is past. Okay, fine. This is the past perfect tense, but this is an incomplete sentence.
There is no second event.
This is the past perfect tense, but if somebody this sentence also to you in a conversation, this is a past perfect tense, because in a conversation everything is clear, but when we are writing something, this sentence is incomplete. The full sentence would should have been somewhat like this: they had played the match when it started raining. When it started raining. Now this is a complete sentence in. This is a complete sentence in. Now two incidents took place in the past simultaneously. They had played the match. They started the match and finished the match in the past. And it started raining in the past also. It started raining in the. Everything is in the past, and this is the complete sentence. However, if somebody says to you that they had played the match. Of course, this is an incomplete sentence, but during conversations, this can be cited as a complete sentence, because whenever two people are speaking or talking to each other, they discuss all issues. So this is the past perfect tense. Earlier also, because we have had here, had and the second form of the verb, had and the second form of the verb. With this notion, I assume that all of you have understood in case of multiple past events, how to describe. The past perfect tense, Reena, in case of multiple past events, you can describe. Now, for example, Reena, can you come and unmute yourself? I want to ask you something. Reena, please unmute yourself.
Yes.
Okay, Reena. Now, I am going to ask you a few questions and you reply to me appropriately. So, Reena, what did you do yesterday? How was your day yesterday? You will tell me and I will go on writing things. Fine?
Yesterday I had my internship duties, so I was really tired yesterday.
What time did you wake up today? Yesterday,
yesterday I woke up at 7:30 a.m.
Yesterday, Reena woke up at 7:30 a.m. Yes, Reena. What next?
Then I got ready and went to the hospital.
Okay, Reena. So after that, she got ready and went to the hospital. So whom did you meet, Reena? Over there, your patient or who? Yes, Reena. Okay, Reena, we are listening to you. What did you do next? Okay, somebody else. Aruna, you can come online. You tell us, what did you do yesterday?
Hello, sir. Good afternoon.
So let us write about Aruna. Aruna, what time did you wake up?
Sir, I woke up at 8 a.m.
Okay, fine. At 5 past 8 a.m.
Yes.
Fine. Then you got ready.
Yes, and I, as I'm an intern, and I got ready and went to the hospital. There I met different patients and took follow-up of the patients.
We met several patients.
And took follow-up, did sampling, and.
And followed up. Not took followed. Followed up. Followed up the patients, then?
There I met my PGs, and they guided me about the ECG sampling and different procedures and how to deal with the EM patients, how to deal the emergency day. It was my first EM day, so I was being guided by the seniors.
Okay, fine. Oh, very nice. Excellent. You had a wonderful test today. We came to know a very constructed way, Aruna. Very nice. After that, you met your PGs who guided you over ECGs, echoes, and several other things.
And yeah, how to deal the EM emergency.
Yes. Emergency and everything. So now, did you see that case, whatever Aruna did yesterday, is in the past tense. So here, as many people were asking me questions as to how to write the literati or a piece of extract of writing when several incidents have taken place in the past, when several events have taken place in the past. Guided her, of course, Reena. But Reena, why did you leave us? Reena, we wanted to know about your happenings of the day yesterday. Why did you leave us there? Okay, fine.
Oh, electricity got suddenly cut off.
Okay, fine. No worries. Next time we'll follow up your day routine then on the next session. Did you see everything over here that we have written is in the past tense, and several incidents had happened. Now suppose Aruna woke up at 8:05 a.m. She had, I'm just changing this sentence a bit. She had got ready when her maid arrived. So here what am I trying to do is, I have just changed this sentence a bit. And I have incorporated here the past tense. Now let us see here. What I have done is that I have just incorporated the past perfect tense here about Aruna. What we have done here is that yesterday Aruna woke up at 8:05 a.m. She had got ready when her maid arrived. So when Aruna's maid arrived in yesterday in the past, Aruna had already got ready. She had already got ready. So this is how we make use of the past perfect tense. Now this is how I was telling you that whenever we are referring to the past perfect tense, what I'm trying to emphasize upon the fact is that the past perfect tense is basically two events in the past. And you can also write it in this manner, that the past perfect tense is basically past into past, or the past perfect tense, or the square to the past tense. Now I will explain to the usage of has had, have had, and had had, and this we will discuss the usage of has had, have had, and had had in our next session. Till now you just revise on the things that I have described to you today. You keep go on wondering about things and just manipulate and construct sentences in your brain, in your mind, while speaking to yourselves. If you have any query, just write to us on the our website or our email address, our email IDs, so that we can resolve your problems regarding this. On the next session, we are going to have a deep knowledge of the usage of has had, have had, and had had. So until then, wish you all the luck for your coming exams and everything. Thank you very much, Teach You Academy, for inviting me. I hope we had a wonderful session today. Thank you very much. Rest to all of you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Manoj sir.